guys, EB Action here, back here with another video. Today I am doing another round review for you guys and of the EPL week 33. So we're going to review every single game in the Barclays Premier League. Sorry that my last four videos have been pretty bad quality of like video, not the camera, or just stock. I haven't done hard enough, but hopefully going to upload two good videos today. That's right, two. I don't know why I've done that. So we're going to review all the games now. So the first game was West Ham and Arsenal. I actually got to watch the first half of this game since Daylight Savings is ending here in Australia, so we get to watch the early games. So I watched the first half, and boy, was it worth it. 18 minutes, Ozil got it, pretty easy goal. So that was 1-0. And then 35, Sanchez doubled it with a great goal. Assist from Iwobi. What assist. Two assists, Danny Welbeck. Go to hell. Iwobi, you're a legend. What a young talent player. But 2-0 there. West Ham haven't lost home since August. So you're like, oh god, they're going to finally lose. But no, Andy Carroll, 44, with a great header. Maybe they can get it. Boom. Oh wait, sorry. Boom. Equaliser just before halftime by Andy Carroll himself again. 2-2, fantastic effort. Can they get him back to West Ham? They're going to take the damn lead with another goal from Carroll. 52 minutes. And that sealed his hat-trick. What a great performance by him. But unfortunately, West Ham couldn't get the win because Shelby managed to score 70 minutes. So 3-0, what a game. Definitely the best game of the round. West Ham, good point, I guess. Well, Arsenal, oh, their Champions League hopes are definitely not on this side, let's be honest. So what an entertaining game that was. Next game, Villa and Bournemouth. Bournemouth, what a legend. First goal came from Cook just before half time. I was about to say the captain, but he's not a captain, but their centre back scored. And Josh King, a very good free transfer from Blackburn, he's done very well, 74 minutes, scored to make it 2-0. And you got a late goal, but that does mean Villa are relegated from the Premier League. They had to win all the rest of their games and score tons of goals, which is not going to happen since they won like hardly any games this year. Well, Bournemouth, they're safe, they've done fantastic. And, man, anyhow, definitely one of the best matches in the Premier League this season. So, brilliant with Bournemouth. Well, Villa, their stuff. See you later, Villa. Swansea and Chelsea. I was a bit surprised by this. Swansea actually managed to do very well in this game. Sigurdsson scoring the only goal. Where was he? 25 minutes. Sigurdsson got the goal. So, that was it. Swansea managed to beat Chelsea, which is kind of a surprise to me. But Swansea are safe, that means. So hopefully they get a new manager next year. And hopefully they'll do well, hopefully better than this year. Oh, Falcao got a game. What a surprise. And Chelsea, disappointing season, of course, for them. Gusidic, disappointing defeat. So good win for the Swansea. A surprising win there. I didn't expect them to win. First win against Chelsea in the Premier League. So, interesting. Watford, Everton to the two out-of-form teams in the Premier League. And, none of them won. It's a draw. McArthur scored just before halftime. And immediately after that, Jose Holibas scored his first goal for Watford. The Greek left back managed to score, and it was 1-0 at halftime, and it remained that way. So Watford, they've really dropped down, and I think they should be safe, but I don't know, some awkward stuff going on. Well, Everton, they're putting it saying that Martinez should go. Should they go? Leave a comment below. I think he should stay, because to be honest, he is a good manager. So they have to play Newcastle in this game. Newcastle, when will you learn? Rafa Benitez, why'd you go there? 4 minutes, Long scored the goal from Pele assist, and 38 minutes, Pele scored from a long assist. So great combination there in that game. So 2-0 Southampton, and they keep smashing them. Wanyama scores his first goal this season in the Premier League to make it 3-0. And Townsend, who shouldn't be playing in the Championship, fantastic goal he scored there, even though it was a consolation. Why are consolation goals always the best goals? I have no idea. But brilliant goal from Townsend, and gee, Newcastle have a lot of players that shouldn't be playing the Championship. Guys like Sissoko, Townsend, Shelby, maybe Rivier. Nah, Rivier's crap. Palace then play Norwich. Two teams struggling down in the zone. But no. Something actually good happened for once for Palace. Only one goal. Punching at 68. Palace win their first game of 206. What? Oh my god, 2016, what am I talking about? 2016, well, Chris Palace, I think they're safe now, even though they've had a disappointing season. Well, Norwich, they're still in the dogfight for relegation. They need to act quick now. Next game is Manchester City versus West Bromwich Albion. Oh, tight win. I don't think Man City can win the league, but a good win, I guess, here. Sessegnon actually got the open at 6 minutes, which was a good goal. And then he conceded a penalty at 19 minutes with Aguero comfortably converted to make it 1-1. So good goal. And Nasri scored at 66, probably man of the match of the game. Scored the winner with his stupid hair. He hasn't scored done well for a while, so that's good for him. So West Brom, they're safe. And Man City, guess that's very good for their Champions League hopes, as you'll see soon why that is good. The next game, Sunderland and Leicester. Leicester bloody City are on bloody fire. Sorry for swearing there. No, it's not even swearing. But man, Leicester and Sunderland go down. I don't think they will. After 0-0 at halftime, Jamie Vardy scored at 66 minutes to get the goal. And he got another one at 95 minutes to seal the game. Sunderland, forget about Sunderland, Leicester, they legit could win the league. What a stunning victory. Jamie Vardy hasn't scored for a while, but he's got his brace here. Oh God, Ranieri, apparently he was so emotional. I mean, why would you not be emotional? Come on. What an amazing season for Leicester. They could win the title, but they could have been 10 points clear, but no, they cannot. But Spurs played against Man U. It took a while for them to score, but Dele Alli scored at 70 minutes to get it 1-0 up. And you may be thinking, oh, can Spurs hold on? No, they're going to hold on. They doubled their lead, 74. Toby Alderweireld, I can never pronounce his name, but he's a fantastic signing from this year, from Atletico Madrid. And surely after that, Lamela scored. So 3 goals in 6 minutes, sealing a very comfortable win. Man U Champions League hopes are straining there. Well, Spurs, can they win the Premier League title for the very first time? They're going to be battling for Leicester there. Should be interesting. Then the last game of the week is Liverpool and Stoke. Liverpool, of course, guys, I think they're rubbish, but they managed to do very well in this game, I've got to be honest. I'll give them credit. Moreno, the defender, scored at 8 minutes. He can always score a goal. 22 minutes, Bojan scored to equalise, so back 1-1. But Jürgen Klopp's men got back in the front by Danny Sturridge, who's back in the side, so good for Ojo, I think one of the young, is that how you pronounce it? Probably not. But he assisted, so good for him. 2-1 Liverpool, and then Divock Origi, who hasn't scored too much this year, gets a 50. And definitely he should be happy because he got added another 165. 4-1 for Liverpool, a pretty easy win once you think about it. But they go nowhere, and Stoke, probably won't make Europa League. But yeah, so that's a very interesting week of the Premier League. Some interesting games. Let's look at the table. Sorry, that's damn Sun's in the way. But Leicester on top by 7 points clear. Spurs are second. Arsenal third. West Ham at 6th. Southampton actually looking good at 7th. I didn't even knew they were that high. Chelsea in 10th. Bournemouth at 11th. But there's still teams below them that still have games left. Everton 14. Jeez Louise. Sam Watford. Palace 10 points clear. While Norwich are 4 points clear. But if Sunderland win their extra game, I don't know who's against. They go 1 point away. Well, Newcastle still have lots of work to do, while Villa are relegated from the Premier League. So, that was a very interesting game week. I hope you enjoyed that video. Hope I'm going to upload loads of these, of course, every week. Please smash a like and check out for more videos, of course. And, of course, next week's round route. So, until then, see you later.